भारतीय टेबल टेनिस के प्लेयर को हार का सामना करना पड़ा। साथियान ने शुरुआत बहुत अच्छी की थी लेकिन उसके बाद अपनी कंसिस्टेंसी को मेंटेन नहीं कर पाए। और इस समय स्टूडियो में मैं हूं नीति रावत, मेरे साथ में है अर्जुन चौधरी। अर्जुन
हाय। नीति, मेजर डिसअपॉइंटमेंट फॉर इंडियन फैंस हु फॉलो टेबल टेनिस एंड looking at the score sheet right now with Sathyan, who was actually leading the best of seven games in this singles men's table tennis event, has lost to his Hong Kong opponent by three games to four, and as a result has crashed out of round one of this men's singles table tennis, and Lam from Hong Kong has now moved on to round two in the men's singles event. We also joined to discuss about this with our expert, Lieutenant General Utpal Bhattacharya. A warm welcome to you on the program once again, sir.
Thank you.
Doordarshan presentation. You must be equally disappointed, especially with the start that Sathyan Gyanasekaran had against his opponent, Lam of Hong Kong, and then losing in that manner. He had an opportunity to come back in the seventh and final game, but unfortunately his nerve gave away.
Absolutely. See, one point, Sathyan got a bye. It was a second round match actually. Lam went up to round three after this. And Sathyan was actually, he became hero in 2018 in Gold Coast Commonwealth Games and Jakarta Asian Games. He got a bundle of medals for his own self and for the country. And his present ranking is 32, though he was ranked 24 sometime back. And he was the only table tennis player, peddler, who has been in the first 25 in the world, only Indian so far. So, lot was expected out of him, and he was moving smoothly, as you said, after losing the first game. He won the next three games pretty convincingly. Second set, he started off with 6-0 lead. Third set also, he was absolutely, I think, 21-7 or so, 11-7. But I don't know what happened. In the last two games, everything got little sucked.
There was a lot of topspin in his return, even while he was serving. And one got the sense that the Hong Kong player, Lam, got used to that spin off the table. And eventually, he was adjusted to it and defeated Gyanasekaran.
Very good point. I think he overdid his topspinning. Overdid. Even in service, he started off with the topspins. Service, you take a stand and then you serve. The reaction time for the opponent who is returning your service is much more. So generally, you don't do the topspin service. And advantage for the Hong Kong player, that he was holding it in the Chinese grip, which is commonly known as the penholder's grip. So he is holding, whether it is for the backhand or it is in the forehand, in this case, whether the front side of the racket or the back side of the racket, every time you cannot visualize. So his defense will always be a little better than his opponent. But the point is, Gunasekaran was playing very well. What happened, I do not know. From the middle of the game number five, he started fading away, fading away, fading away. And thereafter, Lam never looked back. In fact, another point I will point out, that Gunasekaran started taking break at the wrong time. And he was giving them a break when he was not in flow, Lam. The Chinese was missing some points. Gunasekaran took the lead and he was taking the break at the time. Timeouts is also very important, at what point you take the timeout, so that you are in the front foot and you are never in the back foot. So yeah, it's a bad loss for India. Otherwise, the third round Lam has reached, and these players, you know, all these China, Chinese Taipei, Hong Kong, they all practice together.
Well, Nithi, why don't we talk about something positive? Manika Batra, she won against Tintin Ho. Tumske kya prospects honge? Even though in the mixed doubles, Sharad Kamal and Manika Batra lost yesterday to Lin and Cheng of the Chinese Taipei. How would you look at Manika Batra now at this juncture in the women's singles?
Manika Batra is a great fighter. I mean, she's been she was, of course, in top form about a year back. This pandemic hasn't given her much of a competition in the international arena. But she is the prospect now in the singles, and we all hope that she does much better. you have to play your best than what you did earlier.
Mm.
Gunnar Sagaran at no time gave an impression of what he did, of course, in because the teams were same, the players were same. Because if you are good in table tennis in Asian Games, that means you are good in the world also. That is the reason.
उत्पल जी, एक और चीज़ है कि जैसे अभी मानिका बत्रा का हमने जिक्र किया है, लेकिन अगर हम ओवरऑल परफॉर्मेंस आज के दिन की देखें तो इंडियन इज स्टार्टिंग रियली वेल. जैसे टेनिस में भी हुआ, सानिया मिर्जा और अंकिता रायना ने अच्छी शुरुआत की थी वहाँ पे 6-0 के बाद, लेकिन उसके बाद हार गए. साथियान के साथ भी सेम सिचुएशन हुई, शूटिंग में भी वही सेम सिचुएशन कि हम स्टार्ट तो बहुत अच्छा कर रहे हैं लेकिन हम उसे मेंटेन नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, वो कंसिस्टेंसी की कमी नजर आ रही है. इसके पीछे क्या खास कारण नजर आ रहा है?
खास है consistency and the stamina. You see, it used to happen so often in hockey. We are leading by 3-2, we are leading by 4-2, and last 5 minutes we are conceding about one or two goals. Thanks God ye hua nahi New Zealand ka against mein we could hold on to our 3-2 lead. That was yesterday. But otherwise in the last 2 minutes it was Srijesh versus that whole New Zealand team. Yeah, that's the point. That match is never over till the time the final whistle is blown. That's the problem in any of the games, you see.
Liz, we saw that in the tennis as well, as she mentioned earlier. Ankita Raina and Sania Mirza were actually won the first set quite comprehensively 6-0. And then losing the second one 7-6, third one 10-8 to their opponents from Ukraine. So, what about Sutita Mukherjee in table tennis in the women's singles? What are her prospects? Has she crashed out? Is she still in competition? Is she still in play? And how would you rate the table tennis men's players? Do you think they have not lived up to the expectations?
No, actually, we had a lot of hope from Gunnar Sagaran because his ranking presently is higher than Sharad Kamal. Sharad Kamal, this is his fourth Olympics. He is the first Olympics, Gunnar Sagaran. And he had really blossomed in Asian Games and Commonwealth Games, as I was mentioning. And so it's difficult now. It's difficult now. Let's hope Monica and Mukherjee, they live up to the expectations and can reach up to quarterfinals at least. We'll go step by step. Once they reach in the last eight, then it can be seen thereafter. You are talking about Sania Mirza and Ankita Raina losing. Yeah, first set they lost, they won 6-love. Winning 6-love in tennis, you are a tennis player, you know. You have to break the opponent's service thrice. That's a great job done. Second set was a very competitive tennis. It became 6-all. And after that, again, they got blanked out in the tiebreaker. Then our pair lost 0-7. Remember Sania Mirza's fourth Olympics. She is the only women athlete attending fourth consecutive Olympics, Beijing, London, Rio, and now in Tokyo. And third one is a super tiebreaker. They lost 10-8 again. Not that we are expecting some medals from this Indian pairs, but it was expected that they would go cross a couple of hurdles at least. That didn't happen.